Hi everyone, my name is Ramana Reddy. I'm a lawyer from Hyderabad. Today I wanted to discuss an interesting case with you that I read a few days ago. The case was about, somebody had purchased a car in one state and they told the showroom, look, we cannot transport it ourselves. Given it's an expensive car. I think it was the Range Rover or the Land Rover or one of those cars. And that car was being transported, say, from state X to state Y. So what happens is, suppose I buy the car, I go to state X and I say, okay, I buy the car, I drive it around for a bit, I get the temporary registration, and then I tell the showroom, look, I don't want to run the risk of transporting the car from state X to state Y, given the state of the roads. So why don't you put the car on your truck or whatever and just drive it to state Y? And in this case, what had happened was when the truck was transporting the car from state X to state Y, the GST officials stopped the car or the truck, and they said, look, you don't have a waybill for the car, and therefore I'm going to detain the car. Now, I'm sure you know, and even if you don't know, there is a requirement that if you transport goods across, I think, more than 50 or 20 kilometers for business, then you need to generate an e-waybill. And if the value of the goods, I think, is above 50,000 or something like that. Now, in this case, obviously, it's a Range Rover car. They're traveling across state lines. So there was a necessity for generating e-waybills. And, the truck and the car were detained. The owner of the car filed a writ petition in the High Court saying, look, under Rule 138, that is the rule for e-waybills. And the rule says, there's Rule 138 subclause 14. That is the rule that says that, it exempts for a list of goods for which no e-waybill is required to be generated. And one of those exemptions is used personal effects. So anything, if you use it and it is for personal consumption, you don't need to generate an e-waybill. Now, in this case, the question was, is this a used personal effect? Is the Range Rover a used personal effect? Now, the court said, look, the car had already traveled for about, 20 kilometers or 30 kilometers or something like that. So therefore, it was used. But I think the more interesting observation was, and this is in a case that the court had relied on, where they say that, look, the moment I buy a car, then I have to get a temporary registration. And the moment the car leaves the showroom, it becomes used. Because, if I tried to sell a car once the car left the showroom, then the price would half in value. So the court said, if you are transporting a car from state X to state Y, or even within state X, and there is detention, if the car has a temporary registration, if the car has left the showroom dipped in value, then that qualifies as a used personal effect. And if you ever happen to be in the fortunate position of having to transport a car through a truck, an expensive car hopefully, then please note that you don't have to generate an e-waybill. I will drop the link to the case in the description, and you can check it out. I hope that was helpful. Thank you for watching.